Okay, welcome everyone. I'm Chan Sin Chin Prasert and my college, Khom Kit Vieng Wisset. So we are from Nipah Khao, Thailand, Bangkok. So today we are going to talk about the performance tuning and resource management for Valiant, Dedicate, and Share Core flavors. So, okay, agenda for today. The first one is how we design a flavor for public cloud customers. Share core tuning guides, dedicated core tuning guide, and conclusion future works. In our company, we have a marketing team to talk our customer and get their requirement. My marketing team concludes our customer need. The main factor that customer want to use public cloud in Thailand is high availability or HA. And the second is cost and discounts, convenient sales service and pay as you go. So for the high availability, in the last year, we have a session talk at the Berlin with Dr. Apisak. Is talk about how we design the open stack in HA. Yeah, that in the picture we design the concept push the controller in the three side with the all active and we design the edge zone for do the Nova cell controller and we are using the tungsten fabric instead of open switch. Yeah, you can go to watch it again in YouTube. You can search how we design an OpenStack public cloud at scale with fabric networking. So today we are talking about the second factor is a cost and discounts. The first of all, we need to understand the user requirement and design a flavor to fit their requirement. After that, we need to decide the compute node hardware spec for each type. We talk to customer. We can grouping their requirement in the two part. The first part is a non-critical application, like a low traffic web servers, CMS, blocks, dev test servers, or just small database or someone use to keep a coding repository. Yeah, this section I'm called the non-critical application. Yeah, it can down, it can not work at high performance. Yeah, and the second one is a mission critical or performance VM. For the example is a high performance SQL in memory caching, indexing, memcache. Ladies, yeah, JVM, video streaming, and video coding. So here is an example on our customer. They move from on-premise to our cloud. They have a Kubernetes cluster on the for the dev server and production server. So the customer requirement is how to optimize cost for the non-mission critical service and how to maximize the performance and stability for Kubernetes production. Because this customer will provide the POS and vending machine for in the Thailand. Yeah. So after we discuss to customer, we know how to save cost for them. We decide the two flavor group. The first one is a share core flavors, and second one is a dedicated core flavor. The first one, share core flavor, it can be the Kubernetes development cluster, logging server, Git server, OpenSearch, and monitoring. And the dedicated core flavor is will be the Kubernetes production, database node, NAT gateway, or VPN side to side. So, So we are public cloud, right? We need to calculate the cost. That so on the left hand side is cost effective. It's focused to the low medium workload application, burstable CPU, lower cost as possible, and the CPU and RAM will overcommit. Yeah, and so and the right hand side is performance. we are focused to the medium high workload application, sustain CPU performance and minimize CPU and RAM latency, and it will be dedicated CPU and RAM. Yeah. So we design a firmware and a dedicated node together. For the share core, the spec of a compute node that we use is 32 core, 64 thread, and 768 gigabyte of RAM. The CPU and RAM ratio will be high, is around 1 to 10. Yeah. And the dedicated core firmware is use the CPU pinning, so there are no overcommit, right? CPU and RAM ratio will be lower, is around 1, 2, 3, 4. The spec of a dedicated compute node that we are using is 68 core, 96 thread with two socket. It's a total 192 thread. Yeah. And memory is 500 gig per of RAM. So when you have a share core and dedicated core compute node in the same cluster, you need to create a host aggregate for grouping that compute node. So here is an example. We are create the first line is a grouping of a dedicated node, and second line is a grouping of a share node. After that, we are using the feature of Nova scheduler named aggregate instant extra spec. So we create the host aggregate, right? And we create a firmware for share core and dedicated core. And how to map the firmware to host aggregate. Yeah. You need to add the firmware metadata name aggregate instant extra spec to firmware metadata and add into the host aggregate. When user launch the instant with match the value of the firmware metadata, it will run into the compute node correctly.
For the resource type we offer, we provide two types of firmware: one share core firmware and dedicated core firmware. We got a lot our concept from hyperscaler cloud. If we look at example of hyperscaler, we can see that even with the same specification, performance testing score by Geekbench are not same. So we calculate the price per performance ratio, you will see which one is valuable.
Yeah, because customer ask cloud service provider, we want 4 core, 8 gig, right? But they don't care about the performance that we get. So here is an example on the AWS. Yeah, we just test on the Geekbench of all the favor and calculate cost and performance ratio. Yeah.
Our public cloud user can adjust the resource type to optimize cost or service to focus on performance with use residing.
Yeah, here is a benefit for do the share and dedicate in the same cluster. Because a user can decide by themselves. from share to dedicate and dedicate to share.
For share core overcommit ratio is 1:8 by default. That means if we have 16 core in our inventory, we can utilize up to 128 vCPU. When creating a share core favor, we specify the option HW CPU policy equal share.When create favor or set favor.
Yeah, actually, a default OpenStack favor that you create is a share core. Yeah.
Yes. An important aspect for share core is that we have to impose what is known as a CPU quota limit. If we don't do this,The problem that appear is unequal CPU usage, high congestion, performance not stability. Given the chance for some VM to use too much CPU, which impact other VM, since each VM share CPU usage. This example,that we use in setting CPU quota limit when creating share core favor. This is an example. Next, let's see how creating favor that dedicate different from share. The difference is that we add the option CPUPolicy equal dedicate is different from share. When creating a favor or set a parameter favor. For dedicate core, when dumping the revert XML, we will see is the mapping between each compute CPU and each VM vCPU.Is one by one.
Yeah, for the share core, it do like a pool of a CPU range, right? And the vCPU of VM can run on any CPU in that pool. But in the dedicated core, the vCPU will map 1:1 to the hypervisor CPU. So it's quite guaranteed and the latency is good. Yeah.
Let's look at how configuration Nova.conf difference between share core and dedicated core. The important parameter related to share core are the configuration of overcommit and CPU share set. For dedicated core, the important parameter is CPU dedicated set. When we config as mentionedThe inventory collection of resource in placement service, we use vCPU for share core, pCPU for dedicated core.
The number of CPU share set is a CPU core ID. If you have 128 core, you can add up to 128 core. So.It means you can mix the share core and dedicate core in the same compute. Yeah. But please do not overlap the CPU range. So this slide talk about the heap page. So last slide, we talk about the CPU, right? And now we need to improve the memory also on the dedicate core favor.In the Linux system, there are page table. The page table is for store mapping virtual memory address to the physical memory address. The virtual memory address are used by the application VM instance. Yeah. The default of Linux page is for KB. So you mean, more page you have, more time that you can find the page mapping into the physical memory, right? The concept of pure page is increase the page size from 4 KB to 2 megabyte or 2 gig. Yeah. Here is an example. If you use the default page and VM required to use the 2 gigabyte of RAM, you will have about the 500,000 page. It's a lot. But if you use the huge page, the page will be increased to 1,000 page. So let me conclusion about the benefit of pure page. So page size will be increased, right? And number of page will be decreased. Yeah. And the reduced page table walking is faster. Yeah. So it's no swapping and no case swap the operation, and the overhead of operation will be less. Yeah. So two things you need to do. The first one, you need to enable the huge page on the club parameter like this. Just add parameter here. Default huge page, 1 gig. 1 gig is mean page size will be 1 gig. And huge page, 400 is mean you will have page, 400 page. And you need to update GAP and reboot the server. And the second, you need to add the favor metadata HW main page size large. It tell Nova to use huge page on this instance. Yeah.
I will provide example to build a favor for dedicated core with huge page. We will need to specify the option HW CPU policy equal dedicate and HW mem page size equal size of huge page. This example, we use 1 gigabyte for huge page. Okay. Here is an example for resource provider for both dedicated core and share core on the same compute. Yeah. Observe that PCPU is inventory. PCPU inventory for dedicated CPU, which does not have an allocation ratio or overcommit. PCPU does not allocation ratio or overcommit. And vCPU is inventory for share CPU. You will notice there is an allocation value which is overcommit value. It's vCPU and have allocation. A placement service will not multiply for us if we working on capacity planning.
Okay, let me conclusion. We decide the share core favor and dedicated core favor for customer. We separate the compute node for share core and dedicated core. So we use the host aggregate and favor to mapping by the aggregate instance ecta spec. Yeah. So future work is we plan to upgrade to the latest version of Nova because we are interested new feature is named is about the strategy to reduce the CPU power consumption when unused. Yeah. So it's we haven't tried yet, but it can reduce the power consumption of dedicated node. That is, thank you.
Thank you. Okay.
So do you have any question? Okay.
So you mentioned in order to have dedicated physical CPUs for virtual CPUs, you ping virtual CPUs on certain physical CPUs. So my question is, do you need to live migrate or cold migrate these virtual machines? And if they do, how does this CPU pinging work for VM migrations? Because if your hypervisors have different CPU models, different numbers of cores, it may work on, you know, the pinging may work on one hypervisor but not another, right? So I wonder if you've encountered that and how that works in your case.
Actually, the zip, here, right? Actually, Nova Compute will map this one. When we live migration, Nova Compute will recalculate the CPU. Yeah, so normally it can live migrate from another compute.
So for your hypervisors, do they have the same number of CPUs?
No.
And same number of cores?
No.
So the pinging is just a range and Nova will figure out the details, you mean?
Nova Compute will find the available of CPU of that compute and will remapping again. Yeah.
Okay, so Nova will find another hypervisor with the same physical CPU set up, and that's how VM migration works. Okay, thank you.
Any more question? Okay, thank you. Yeah, one more. Oh. One more here, okay.
Sorry, only one question. Why did you combine the shared and the dedicated compute together? Why not do one compute with all the dedicated CPUs and one compute with all the shared CPUs?
I didn't share in my production. I just told about it can be possible. Yeah, but in our production, we separate it. Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay.
All right.
Okay, thank you. Thank you.